And one thing that I hate about movies are sad movies for no reason. Meaning, you have sometimes certain directors that would make a movie and the movie's really sad and you're just crying. And they try to, if like, I don't know if they're like, they're trying to, celebrate themselves so that people think that they're like very good directors and writers because they're making this shit sad as fuck and sentimental. And I think that that is not an achievement. Like, I think it's easy to convey sadness. I think what's hard is to convey comedy, to convey funny, to make something funny, genuinely funny. I think that's really hard. But to make a scene where it's sad or a movie that's just like somebody got cancer and we're looking at the whole process of them getting cancer and dying and leaving kids, like, I don't know, that's probably a plot in many movies, right? I'm not talking about one specifically, but all these movies about sadness, about somebody getting, there are a few of them that have like an actual deeper message and a happy, like there it is sad, but it leaves like a happy message. But a lot of them are just sad for the sake of being sad, and they feel, the people that create these movies, that oh, I'm amazing because I'm making people cry. I think that's easy. I think making people cry is easy, There's so many fucked up shit in the world that you just have to put it in the screen, and that's gonna be sad. Like, life is fucked. And I personally don't like watching movies to be sad. Like, movies to me are an escape for me to imagine a better world. We already live in a world filled with tragedy and fucking illnesses and fucked up shit and misery. So art is supposed to make you happy. Or sometimes it might not be just happiness, it might be a nostalgic feeling, but it's not sadness. In the spectrum of feelings, you have happy on one side and you have sad on the other, and then you have many things in the middle. And those are all valid. I think there's sometimes a movie doesn't have to convey a super happy message, but it could be something in the middle where like it tells you certain lessons that are important, that are hard to swallow, but it also puts it with certain comedy. Like, those are mixes that go well. But if you're just giving me sad, to me, you're not a good movie maker. You're just giving me the easy shit, You're just making me cry. I mean, and think about it. Like, and people say this. Like, being a dramatic actor is a lot easier than being a comedic actor, because to be funny on screen is a lot harder. It takes a lot more skills. And I also feel this way. I feel this way talking. But I'm not even a fucking actor, right? But I'm here talking with a lot of confidence, like I know about this shit. But it does seem that way, that an actor to do dramatic roles, it's not that big of a deal. I mean, there is obviously skills involved, but when you need to do comedy, real comedy, like comedy that strikes well, not fucking goofy shit comedy, which there's a lot of these days as well. But when like actual, like really good, like for example, Norm Macdonald, right? We just had one of the greatest comics, my favorite comic, probably passed away recently, Norm Macdonald. And the way that he was able to put jokes, in a way where he wasn't meaning to be smart, but when you get the joke, you know that he was being really smart about it. If you haven't heard this guy, Norm Macdonald, you need to hear this guy. Just search on YouTube. He has so many videos of him being in late night shows. Of he used to be on SNL on the news live, where he would like read fake news, And they fired him because he wouldn't stop making jokes about O.J. Simpson back in the time when the trial happened and he got acquitted for the murders. But I mean, this guy's amazing. But what I'm saying is, there's people that can make funny in a such an organic way, and that is super hard. Making me sad on a movie, that's not hard. Sorry. So that's just something that I wanted to touch on.